Moving forward with our files, I'd like to take a few moments and talk about the concept of file types. Now, basically, a file type associates a binary value or a collection of binary values called a file with a program that uses it or can edit it. For example, in a Windows environment, .txt denotes a text file and is generally associated with Notepad unless you've changed that association. Now, the really important thing here is the association between a file type and the program that uses it. Configuration files, for example, are generally text files. Bitmap files and GIF files are generally image files. And if we want our operating system to handle those files as if they are the type of file that they were meant to be, then we have to have file types. Now, it gets kind of tricky in a Linux environment because we're not using the associations that we use in a Windows registry environment, and we're not using file extensions that we would be using in a Windows environment. So this means we have to rely on the operating system to use an alternate method to detect a file type. And that's where the actual magic file or the file command comes into play. Basically, at the beginning of every file, down at the hexadecimal level, there is a header that contains information that links the file to an associated type. So basically, when you execute a file or script or any of those things, the Linux operating system is going to check its known database or its magic file or any other available sources to see where it can find an associated program or file type. So it's actually a little bit complex in how it does those things. So it's not able to just scan through a database and find a source. We've listed a couple of things here, such as strings, which are basically text values inside of text files. We've also mentioned character sets, such as ASCII-2. Now, there's actually a built-in piece of the operating system or command that allows us to view file types if we don't know what they are. So this is kind of a kickback from not having file extensions. So we might not be able to look at it and tell what it is, but we can use the file command to determine additional information based on that file's header. So let's actually take a look at that real quick. Now, as we mentioned before, we've created our example files. And in a scenario where I don't know what these example files are, I can simply type file and example, and it says ISO 8859 in the English language, and it's a text file. So this actually breaks it down for us so that we can tell exactly what information we need to know about the file type that we're dealing with. Now let's take another example. This is actually a GunZip compressed data. It shows the existing or original file name, the last modification date, and it even shows the compression type that is used and on what operating system. In this example, we used maximum compression in the Unix operating system. So it's built for that particular OS. So this is a great example of where the file command can come in handy, because we might not have known that that's a tarball file buried inside of a GunZip file, or vice versa. Now, another example of this is, remember that example is actually a duplicate of the Anaconda config file, which we brought back originally as an English text file. So if we run the same command against the install.log file, this, even though it is a text file, is actually an ASCII-2 text file, which for our intents right now is really not that much different. They're still both text files. Now, those differences will come into play a little bit later.